Oh, shit. She doesn't teach math.
Guys, it had to be Miss Bartleson. And she has such great science.
But Miss Bartleson just
missed it. One time, she gave it to the second grade
Good evening. The time is now 6:04 p.m. and we are ready to begin our regular scheduled meeting for November 16, 2023. I'd like to thank you all for joining us this evening. Members of the public who desire to address the board on any topic related to board work must sign the roster before 6:30 p.m. It's located to the back of the room there. Norma, would you please conduct our roll call?
Yes, sir. Mrs. English?
Here.
Ms. Frazier?
Here.
Mrs. Salazar?
Here.
Mr. Williams?
Here.
Mrs. Wills Hill?
Here.
Michelle Rawlings?
Here.
Candelaro Dionisio?
She's excused this evening. Thank you. This evening we have some of our students from Sand Creek International. We have Courtney Johnson, Aureli Alvarez Navarez, Kiesha DeShazor, Aubrey Siegfried, Isabella Siegfried, Melvin Kingo, Harper Siegfried, Jackson Siegfried, and Brooklyn DeShazor. Nice. The floor is yours.
Good evening. My name is Amy Nunn. I am the proud principal of Sand Creek International. Thank you for hosting us tonight.
Sorry, Ms. Nunn. We need to start with the pledge.
Oh, I meant the floor is theirs,
oh.
Not yours.
Sorry.
My apologies.
No, that's okay.
Statement. I got you, don't worry about it. Harrison School District 2's mission statement is to graduate college and career-ready students with the knowledge, skills, attitudes, and behaviors to personally succeed and contribute to the common good. Item number 3 to adopt our agenda, and I would just need a motion.
Mr. President, I move that the agenda be approved as stated.
Second.
Motion by Mrs. Wills Hill, second by Dr. English. All those in favor? Aye. We have ourselves a meeting. Item number 4, showcasing our schools. Item 4.1, showcasing Sand Creek International.
Well, you all know
Principal
me.
Principal Amy Nunn.
So again, I'm Amy Nunn.
Yes, ma'am.
Super proud principal of Sand Creek International. I have some amazing students with me tonight who have fought us for slides. The adults in the room will not get to talk much, so just be prepared for that. But thank you for hosting us. We are so excited to be here and very, very proud to work under the board that supports schools like you guys do. So I would love to invite up Areli and Kiesha, and they will tell you all about the amazing staff and students we have at Sand Creek.
Hi, my name is Areli. I'm here to introduce our student population. In total, we have 599 students. 420 of them are elementary, and 179 are middle school. Our ethnicity percentage is 60% Hispanic, 17% white, 14% black, 9% multiracial, less than 1% Asian, less than 1% Native American / Alaskan Native. Our free and reduced lunch is 82%. Our CLE students is 17%. Our students on IEP is 16.5%, and lastly, our gifted students is 3.5%.
Hi, my name is Keisha, and I'm here to introduce our amazing Sand Creek staff. We have 24 classroom teachers, 9 special education teachers, and 10 special education pairs, 3 CLDE teachers, and 1 CLDE pair, 1 half-time math interventionist, 1 full-time reading interventionist, and 4 instructional pairs. 8 specials and elective teachers, 2 counselors, 2 social workers, and 1 school psych, 2 registered behavior techs, and 1 board certified behavior analyst, 1 speech pathologist, and 1 speech assistant. We have 1 occupational therapist and 1 occupational therapist assistant, 4 custodial staff, 4 kitchen staff, 4 office staff, and 3 administrators and 3 coaches / coordinators.
Hi, my name is Brooklyn, and at Sand Creek, students have a lot of support. Our teachers, admin, and families are always there when you need them.
All right, so now you have to hear the adults speak for a little bit. I'm Ms. Dolbear. I'm one of the assistant principals at Sand Creek. So we just wanted to touch base on some of the ways that we support our students specifically for reading. And we use targeted MTSS methods to be able to help our students make improvements. We use PDSA and focus folders, and that is a helpful way to organize intervention for our students and a way for us to provide structured and focused approaches to make sure we meet all academic needs.
Hi, I'm Doug Larkey, assistant principal at Sand Creek. So we also identified some gaps in math that we needed to close. So we were able to hire a math interventionist, 0.5 professional interventionist. We have done a lot of teacher professional development around math. We've had great minds come in and do full days where we've run into every math teacher in our school and given us great feedback and areas to work on.
Staff are committed to supporting all students in character development.
Students at Sand Creek are not only taught how to be great citizens, we are able to earn using prizes and can participate in games with our teachers.
Some of us have even been principal for a day.
This year, we have a team of teachers dedicated to make community and family engagement more meaningful. Community and families have already helped to improve our school.
Hi, I'm Parker. We have volunteers who tutor us in reading, math, and help coach our sports and clubs. Volunteers did painting projects to improve our playground.
Pride Soccer also donates coats and stuffies to us during trick or treat and for stocking and stuffy days.
Hi, my name is Courtney. We have a lot of opportunities for our students to participate in after-school clubs and sports. Some examples of our clubs are Lego clubs, drama clubs, and football clubs, and soccer club. Our fourth and fifth graders get to participate in basketball, and our middle school students get to join sports such as volleyball, cross country, basketball, and much more. Sand Creek also offers several leadership and academic opportunities for our students through PEAK education, educating children of color, and the UCCS pre-collegiate program. And I'd also like to give a shout out to our Yeti girls soccer team for getting first in the district.
Sand Creek is a performance school as rated by Colorado Department of Education. And just some highlights just to share, ELA is an area of strength for Sand Creek. In elementary school, we actually exceeded the expectations in ELA in the area. In elementary, we exceeded those expectations in growth. In middle school, we met achievement expectations, and we're very proud that our English language learners exceeded expectations on access testing.
Yes.
This is just a visual of our instructional roadmap, and we use this to make sure that we stay focused on our vision and goals for the year so that we don't stray off by adding a bunch of new things without prepping for them the right way. We do share this with our staff at every TLC meeting to make sure that we stay focused on where are we and where are we going.
Hi, I'm Bella, and as an Ivy school, we participate in service action projects each school year.
Hi, I'm Aubrey. All of those projects are designed to make our community a better place. Our school has been working together to make a positive impact in our community. This year, we participated in a project called Socktober. Socktober is all about helping people in our community who might need a little extra support. Socks might seem like a small thing, but for someone who doesn't have a small place to sleep, a pair of clean socks can make a big difference.
We hosted a school-wide drive that collects socks and canned goods. We gathered 421 pairs of socks for the local shelter, and 682 cans of food for the local food bank. Socktober wasn't just about collecting things. It was about coming together and showing that even small actions can add up to something big when we all do.
So our area of focus, which was highlighted in the map, is restorative practices continuing. with a focus on connection circles or the proactive pieces of it. Increasing math growth, as Ms. Nunn mentioned, that's very focused, and maximizing instructional time.
While Sand Creek has many strengths, we wanted to highlight two areas that make our school the best.
Hi, I'm Melvin, and at Sand Creek, student voice matters. We get to lead our school and share ideas with our student council and student led councils.
Our student council was started by us. We advocated for a group of student leaders to help us with assembly, sphere weeks, and more.
We have meetings that we lead, and we talk about what we want to make better in our school by adding our voices and opinions to help all students enjoy school activities.
This year, we have added student-led videos and video announcements that we get to share important information with the whole school. Like upcoming events, birthdays, and even fun facts. It's like being a news reporter for our school and everybody loves it.
At our school, we get to be the captains of our own memberships. We can learn about topics we're interested in and set sail on interesting learning adventures.
Our teachers help guide our learning by working with us as we develop the skills because they don't have the skills to answer. They help us build our own understanding. They work with us to make sure that we're learning in the best way possible.
This helps us develop skills and confidence so we can handle learning things.
Thank you. We appreciate your time.
Speaking voices, so I have expectations that you all should be sitting on this dais one day. Guys, present yourself very well. No need to be shy. You know exactly what you came to say, and you guys are Yeti strong, so you guys did an amazing job.
I am very proud of what I saw this evening, and I'm looking at the mom in the back with the red. I don't know if she memorized someone's part or something, but I saw nothing but pride. And as I walked through the halls of the school, are you the dad too with the big smile? Is that you?
No, I'm brother.
Brother. Oh, big brother?
I'm the big brother.
But anyway, I'm just always impressed whenever I come to Sand Creek, and I had an opportunity to come a few weeks ago, and no one knew who I was at the front office, so I fixed that with cookies, so you will always remember who I am coming in. But anyway, thank you so much for all your additional efforts. Everyone did a very impressive job, but we're just really proud of you.
Thank you.
Ms. Nunn, you've been at Sand Creek.
This is my second year as principal at Sand Creek.
Well, you are doing a phenomenal job with these students, and thank you so much.
It's all about them and all because of them, and I have an amazing admin team that backs me and great teachers and staff.
Thank you very much.
Thank you all for the work you do at Sand Creek. I want to say, and thank you for giving the students a voice. You all did amazing tonight. Thank you.
I just want to say, you guys are amazing. I love the clarity of your voice. I love your confidence. And just wow. I mean, if these opportunities were available when we were younger, man, we'd be so much further. So we are expecting big things from you all. Thank you.
last time I went to Sand Creek, I was there for the student achievement rally that you guys had. We'll be having that this year as well.
Renaissance Assemblies, Miss Dolbear is the proud leader of those.
Yes, I will volunteer again this year for you.
You saw they were dressing like toilet paper.
Last time it was pies to the face.
Yeah.
So I will volunteer for the tissue rollout again this year. Yes, ma'am. Thank you, Miss Nunn.
Thank you.
And we're going to have all of you all come up here. We want to get a picture with you all.
And thank you parents, to all the parents and all of
Excited at all, high five. Good job. All right, I'll keep us moving right along to item 4.2. We have our report from our student board rep this evening, Mr. Mitchell Rawlings. And the floor is yours, sir.
Excuse me, that doesn't mean she will. She won't be doing it tonight.
Thank you.
I wanted to start off my update by saying that Sierra did beat Harrison at the football game.
Is that why Candelora decided not to join us this evening?
She was supposed to wear red
tonight. Oh, couldn't be seen in public that way.
Okay, and then this past Monday was the official start for winter sports, and this week is the last week before Thanksgiving break, which I'm very excited for.
Extremely proud of you, Mr. Rawlings, and Sierra for winning, what did we call it, the Superintendent's Cup? Winning the Superintendent's Cup this year, so another round of applause for Sierra. Not bad, first year principal, win right out the gate, right? Got high expectations, that's right.
I love you, Mr. Rawlings.
Several recognitions this evening, and so I am going to go down the line, pause in between, that way we can give them their proper due. First up, item 5.1 Harrison High School Band. The Harrison High School Panther Marching Band had an excellent season this fall. They hosted two competitions, which brought 37 bands to our campus to perform. The band traveled out of state and competed at the Bands of America Arizona Regional in Flagstaff, Arizona. They took fourth in their division at this event, and at the CBA Southern Regional a few weeks later, the Harrison High School Band took second place and qualified for CBA State Championships. They finished the season in eighth place at state semifinals with their highest score of the season. The band scored a 65.9, which is higher than any score they earned during the 2022 season. Congratulations to the Harrison High School Panther Marching Band. Next up, item 5.2, Harrison Cross Country. Jake Colson received first team honors in the CSML South meet this year and was the first male to qualify for the state cross country meet since 2008 for Harrison High School. Jake placed 43rd individually at the 3A Colorado State Cross Country Championships. Mr. Colson, would you join us? High school soccer team. The Harrison boys soccer team went undefeated through their regular season with a record of 10-0-5 and won their first outright league championship. In addition, they also won the program's first ever state playoff game. Senior Emmanuel Sanchez was voted League Player of the Year, while Coach Bridger Stapleton received the Coach of the Year award. Highlights for the team off the field include going camping, their senior night taco tailgate, and attending a Switchbacks game. They have proudly built their season success on the pillars of discipline, commitment, and trust. The team would like to thank the parents, staff, and community members who have supported them throughout their season.
game in Whitefield, one of our players went down on the field, and these coaches stepped in and started CPR to save this child's life. This child is now able to play sports, but these coaches gave everything to make sure one of their players was okay, and that goes above and beyond for what you do.
Coach Minka, you were not listed in that first piece, and so to give you proper recognition, that is Coach Jeff Minka as well. Item 5.5. We have Sierra High School softball team. The Sierra softball team won the CHASA Regional Championship and competed in the state tournament for the first time in 20 years. Thank you all. Recognition award presented to Miss Cynthia Jacquette. The Association for Supervision and Curriculum Development, or ASCD, is organized at the national level and operates for professional learning resources for educators at all levels. Each year, ASCD invites nominations for its Emerging Leaders program and submits them to a rigorous screening process. The goal is to identify a cohort of professionals who are relatively new to education, vet who have demonstrated a desire to grow, to effect change, to drive education forward. Those who are selected are then given access to ASCD's wealth of resources and tasked with making significant contributions of their own during their two-year term. She was recently named president-elect of the Colorado Affiliate Board of ASCD itself. Cynthia Jacquette is proud and honored to be recognized as a global member of the 2023 cohort of ASCD Emerging Leaders and is excited to use her newly acquired leadership skills as the assistant principal at Sierra High School. She currently serves as the board president of Educating Children of Color, working to bring educational equity and opportunities to all students. Thank you, Cynthia Jacquette.
Over.
coaches, you are more than welcome to stay, but you are also more than welcome to go home. So it's up to you. We'll take just a little pause if you want to step out. Thank you, thank you. Congratulations to all of our amazing students and families.
Yes. To address the board on any topic related to board work are welcome to do so at this time. Speakers must limit their remarks to not more than 3 minutes and appoint a spokesperson if the concern is a group concern. Personal attacks will not be allowed. Any focus on an individual and calling a person out by name will end a speaker's comment time. The board will not respond to any public comment. We will review the information presented and may provide responses as needed at a later time. I'm looking at our sign-in sheet here. I have Ms. Brooke Hone, Paul Davies, and Daniel Dudfield. The topics here all seem to be the same, so I will give you a moment to decide whom would be your spokesperson. No, ma'am, not on the same topic. And from being the same school, I would assume that these are all related.
I did have one extra topic that I'd like to talk about for me to look at. It was different than theirs. Staffing.
I will accept your topic of staffing, Mr. Dudfield. And for the school safety piece, will it be Ms. Hone or Mr. Davies?
Yes, my name is Brooke Hane.
Hane?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm sorry.
It's okay, it's one of those names. Am I able to pass? No,
please give them. Please give that to Ms. Harambee Day.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Once you begin, you'll state your name, and Ms. Norman will start your time. You'll take all instructions from there.
Okay.
Thank you.
Brooke Hane. My name is Brooke Hane, and I am a 7th and 8th grade math teacher at Fox Meadow Middle School. This is my 6th year teaching at Fox Meadow and my 8th year teaching overall. And while I've taught through some extreme challenges, I can confidently say that this year has had the most hardships and challenges when it comes to fostering a safe and inclusive learning environment in my classroom and throughout the school. When I look amongst my coworkers, I can see the toll that this year is taking on all of us. I decided to ask my coworkers to sum up how their school year is going in just one sentence, and would like to share a few of them with you all. The paper that I handed out has statements from each of the 20 teachers that were willing to help us out with this. From a teacher who's been teaching for under 4 years, they said, good support from other teachers. Admin is understanding and likable, but disciplinary actions are not effective to quell chaotic behavior in the classroom. Excuse me. From a teacher with 4 to 9 years of teaching experience, I'm overwhelmed by the persistent challenges of managing student behaviors and disrespect, an absence of support from administrators, hearing our hands are tied, and a daily sense of hopelessness when I think about the seemingly insurmountable task of fostering a positive and safe learning environment. From another teacher who's been teaching 4 to 9 years, this year teaching has been chaotic with discipline and the blurred lines of it. From another teacher with 4 to 9 years teaching, this year has felt disorganized and unpredictable due to the lack of accountability for our students and their poor behavior choices, leaving students and staff feeling unsafe and as if their well-being is not important. From a teacher who's been teaching over 10 years, a lack of progressive discipline has led to an increase of violence and gang mentality, which is negatively affecting the learning environment, specifically whistling throughout all of our school hallways and classrooms. From another teacher who's been teaching over 10 years, I'm overwhelmed with student behaviors, lack of consistency with discipline, constant parent phone calls.
Yeah, 30 seconds.
Okay. Little to no support, constant coverage, and a desire to quit. Another teacher. This year has been a year of emotional and social abuse of teachers by students, leaving us feeling unsafe, drained, burned out, not wanting to endure this abuse anymore. From one more teacher. My daily focus is managing unruly behaviors, and I feel more like a prison warden than a teacher. Our current systems are unsustainable, and students, staff alike are feeling unsafe.
Thank you, Ms. Hunt. Mr. Duffield. You'll state your name and then begin. You'll take all instruction from Ms. Harmday.
Yes. Duffield. My question about staffing in particular, I know across the board we have very low numbers, and I know we're trying to get them, but what are we doing particularly for special ed? The reason being is this afternoon one of our center-based teachers quit her position. She couldn't take it anymore, and she said, I'm done. Luckily, our principal worked out a situation that, for right now, is occupying that position, but I've also learned that a staff member in my classroom that supports my significant support needs students will not be returning next semester. And with that being said, there is a magnitude of needs that we must address within the special education program, within all educational programs. And if we don't are not able to have the staff to address those needs, we are not meeting the needs of our students. And when we fail our students, we fail everybody. So my big question is, how are we addressing staffing? How are we getting more people into the school?
Thank you, Mr. Duffield. Us along to item number 7, matters reserved for board action. To give notice to the public, these topics have been discussed at a prior date, and we are simply solidifying those actions previously taken. Item 7.1, update OE 11 instructional program policy. And for item 7.2, I would just need a motion to approve said item.
I move to approve policy change to OE 11 instructional program.
Second.
Motion by Ms. Frazier, second by Dr. English. All those in favor?
Aye.
Item so moved. Moving us right along to item number 8. Department updates. Item 8.1, concurrent enrollment by Lalika Belay.
So board, just as a reminder, we are doing department updates periodically just to keep you informed of what's happening in our schools. Our concurrent program is one of our flagship programs, and our students desire to go to our high schools to have access to this. Dr. Lalika Belay has taken it on fully and has done a great job, so she's gonna share kind of where we have been and where we're going with the program. And you get to see Mr. Bristol first.
Just briefly. And we do get to have some student voice in this as well, so you can look forward to that. I do want to mention that we offer a lot of ways in Harrison School District 2 to get college credit in high school. and concurrent enrollment is one of those. And Dr. Lokoble is going to be talking to you specifically about that way of getting college credit while in high school.
As Mr. Bristol mentioned, concurrent enrollment is just one of the many ways that we have available for students to earn college credit while they are in high school. Specifically within concurrent enrollment, we have typically three different ways that students can earn college credit. Students take classes with us on the high school campus. We have instructors that come down from the college and teach classes right in our own classrooms.
Could you lean in just a bit towards the mic?
Sure, sorry.
Thank you.
Those classes that are on our high school campus are typically ideal for students who are in the 9th and 10th grades. We do start students as early as 9th grade in concurrent enrollment. It's also ideal for students who are just exploring college, maybe not sure if it's right for them. And for students who are in our programs like construction and education that we hold on the high school campus. We also allow students to go to Pikes Peak State College campus to take classes or online. That's ideal for students who either thrive in an online environment or are looking to earn their associate's degree but start late in high school. We also started Career Start this year. This is a program that allows students to go to the college campus. We provide transportation for them to go, and that is a program that allows students to earn industry certification for the field that they are going into after high school. So currently we have 202 students that take concurrent enrollment in some form. We have most of our students come from Harrison, quite a few from Sierra, and then just kind of getting into our Aspire Online Academy, and a few also from Career Readiness Academy. Two of our programs that we're really proud of are our construction program and our teacher cadet program. So construction, we currently have 15 students taking classes at Harrison High School. We bus students over from Sierra to take that program. Those students are earning industry certification and also college credit at the same time. Teacher cadet, similar. We're currently running that at Sierra with plans to expand to Harrison next year. And those students are earning not only college credit, but experience in the classroom. So our instructor, Ms. Randall, is taking students into the elementary and middle schools and having them actually teach classes, and it's been a wonderful experience for them. Our future teachers are looking great. I did want to highlight Career Start. It's something that we're hoping to expand in the future. We currently have 17 students, and these are all of the different programs that students can take through Career Start. It will take us continuing providing transportation for that, and this is a huge opportunity for our students who are ready to go into the workforce after high school. This program allows them to earn what they need to step into the workforce. This is a great opportunity for our students. I'm very excited and proud that we were able to make this happen this year. In 2023, we graduated 35 students with their AA, AAS, or AS degrees. And 15 of those 35 graduated with honors from the college. Mm-hmm. And then a few later graduated with their high school diplomas. We are on track this year to graduate 21 students with associate's degrees. ranging from AA, AAS, and AS degrees. Some of the areas of strength in concurrent enrollment is our partnership with Pikes Peak State College. We have a very strong partnership with the high school programs and other departments at the college that make it all possible for us, and have been able to alleviate some of the challenges that we were facing. Another area of strength is that we're able to give students individualized advising appointments. That's something that is unique to D2. A lot of other districts do not have that particular aspect of concurrent enrollment. So each student gets one meeting at least every semester to determine their courses for the next semester, look at what the job prospects are, to determine what is going to be best for their course selections in the future. So academic performance of concurrent enrollment students is overwhelmingly good. We have a much higher pass rate. I'm still working on the final number, but we have a much higher pass rate for our students than the normal college classes. So students that take English 1021 with our staff are passing at a much higher rate than they are on the college campus for traditional students. So our academic performance is really good. The way that we're contributing to the common good is that D2 students are earning over almost 2,500 credits per year. And students are saving over $400,000 a year in tuition. This is where I would like Misha to speak on the personal development and success about his experiences in concurrent.
Concurrent enrollment is something I will always be grateful I can do. From the beginning of my experience with the program, my eyes have been open to the real-life thing that college is. It really isn't the same as high school, and to experience college classes within the environment of my high school while earning both college and high school credits is what makes it worth it for me. I am preparing myself for the next 4 to 6 years of my life right now, improving and excelling while I have the room and am as comfortable as I can be to do so.
Thank you so much. There are a couple of areas of growth that we're working on in concurrent enrollment. Some of these are bigger challenges than others, but we are working on them, and proudly so. As we got into this year and looked at numbers, we realized that there is a gap in special education students and CLDE students. So we're working on increasing those numbers, making this program more equitable for our students in those demographics. Also working on ICAPS, using ICAPS to help determine students' pathways and the courses that they're going to take, and really what it is that they want and what they need for their future. And then also using the CLEP test, which is College Level Examination Program. This is a test that allows students who are already fluent in a language or already versed in a topic can take a test in order to earn college credit. We have several students every year who take the CLEP test for Spanish and earn 13 college credits doing so. This is a good way for students to test out of some of the stuff that they really just don't need to take, and especially for our already fluent Spanish speakers, and we've had German also students test into that. It's a way for them to earn those credits for high school as well as for college. If they're already fluent in a language, they deserve to earn the credit for that. And that was
Thank you, Dr. Belay. Thanks to my fellow members. Any questions for Dr. Belay?
Thank you so much. Question, your teacher cadet program, do these students offer tutoring for other students?
They They don't, but that's a great idea.
I'm really pleased to hear about getting sped students and other with challenges into these opportunities as well, because we want to be equitable across the board and give everyone opportunities. So thank you for expanding that. And then the Jumpstart?
Career Start.
Career Start. So my daughter also was a part of the concurrent enrollment, and that gave her that really boosted up her GPA as well. But when it even came time to be in the college setting, I believe that she had a better mindset because she had walked on the campus and been in the campus atmosphere. In some cases, and of course she was taking classes at Sierra High School as well, but I see the value, we're experiencing the value now of the concurrent enrollment. So I'm just glad to see it being carried forward. So congratulations on your efforts to expand it and make it better.
Thank you so much.
I just want to share, because it's Dr. Blay and she's very humble, I think there's a couple things you should know about the program and Dr. Blay in general. So Pikes Peak State College tells every other district to do their concurrent like we do in D2. We are the only district that does it the way we do it, and they want other districts to model. And Dr. Blay has been with that since forever, as long as I know. And the other thing is that she didn't mention, but why do kids do so well? That's why. The relationship she has with our kids, if they're not getting their work in, if they're having a challenge, she is calling them, she is texting them, she's bringing their mama in if they need to come in. She is having those relationships. And when I try to guide someone, they're like, well, Dr. Belay said, and like, I listen to Dr. Belay, she knows more than I do. But our kids tell me all the time, that is what got them through concurrent, and that's what gets them through their four-year school. So there's kids at Boulder that I know that tell me they still talk to Dr. Belay to get advice for financial aid, course placement, and so she's an invaluable resource to our district and for our students.
Thank you, Dr. Belay, for all that you do.
We do have some gifts for each board member, because one of our good partners is Pikes Peak State College. We want to make sure you have one of their swag bags as well.
Very nice. Outperforming college students coming from other places and by a large margin, and that's astounding for us. So thank you again, Dr. Belay. I will keep us moving right along to item number 9, superintendent consent agenda. To remind the public, these items have already been discussed. Those items to be approved this evening, item 9.1, November 2023 personnel reports and comparison reports. Item 9.2, September 2023 financial statements. And for item 9.3, I would just need a motion.
Mr. President, I move to approve the superintendent consent agenda item as stated.
Second.
Motion by Dr. English, second by Ms. Frazier. All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Items so moved. Along to item number 10, board consent agenda. Again, these items are just as before. Item 10.1, approval of minutes, board work session, October 5th, 2023, board meeting October 19th, 2023. Item 10.2, OE4 personnel administration monitoring report from Dr. Claudio. And for item 10.3, I would just need a motion.
Mr. President, I move to approve the board consent agenda items as stated.
Second.
Motion by Mrs. Wills-Hill,
Second by Dr. English. All those in favor? Aye. Items so moved. Keeping us moving right along. Item number 11, monitoring board performance. This evening, we have a board recognition for the outstanding work that's been done over the past 4 years. Dr. English will be moving off the board this evening. this year, as she has served her 4 years, a term that her and I started 4 years ago, and the journey has been long. We have a gift for you this evening, but we know you're going to do great work, and your journey is just beginning upon the state level. And so we have an item to present to you, a gift, if you will.
Before you give your speech, I just want to thank you on behalf of the students, families, and staff. You have been a fierce defender of D2 in all circles, and I don't think that's going to change in your role at the Capitol. I am glad to see you have to go to work tomorrow at the special session they called. But we know that if we need something, if we need a voice on the Capitol, we can reach out, we can have kids talk to you, and you will advocate, because D2 is different, daring, and diverse. And you defend us to the end. So thank you for all you do.
Well,
Dr. English, I just wanted to make a comment. The year 2023 has been your year. Dr. Regina English was elected to the State House of Representatives, representing our district, 7th House District 17. And she also attained her doctorate degree all simultaneously while working here as a board member in Harrison School District 2 and going up and down that highway representing our community at the state capitol. So you are a true gem in the community, and we look forward to the better things you're gonna do to represent us. Thank you for your service.
Hey. Well, I tell you what, it has been a pleasure to serve alongside you on the board. She is our favorite fashionista.
And now our favorite doctor.
I'm just always. I'm always like waiting to see what Regina is gonna put together this day, and you never disappoint. I wish you all the greatest of success. I know that there's more in store for you, and you like blow my mind at the things that you accomplish. So just keep doing what you're doing. You're a role model, and I wish you nothing but great success.
I'm not crying.
Yes, you are.
I would just like to say, Regina, Dr. English, for the past 7 years, I've seen you flourish. I've seen you in your lane, and I've seen you bulldoze through challenges. And I just want to say that I'm extremely proud of you. I'm proud to work alongside you. But what most people don't see is the big heart that you have for our students. And so I've seen that. I've seen you cry. I've seen you laugh. I've seen you cheer our kids. And so maybe I will cry. Because that's what's important. I mean, we see that, we see your titles, we see all of the things that you do in public, but I felt fortunate to have seen your heart when you're crying, because your heart is
just can't wait to see what you do at the Capitol and in our nation. Congratulations.
I just want to say I genuinely admire what you do and what you are, and I look forward to what you are going to do. I'm honored to have been able to sit next to you on this board, and I look forward to hopefully following your footsteps.
The last 4 years, even a little bit longer, I remember you walking into my office, coming to pick up your petition packet. It's been a joy working with you. It's been a blessing to me and my family, because you just embraced all of us. And I'm just proud of you. And I'm so excited I got to vote for you to be on, to be my representative. So thank you, God bless you, and don't forget we're here.
First, I just want to say thank you, everyone. I have this mask on because I'm a little stuffy. But I just want to say thank you to everyone. Thank you to our administrative staff. Thank you to all of our educators, our teachers, our principals for the work you do. I truly am passionate about our young people having a high quality education. And I understand that I can have an even greater impact at the state level. So I'm honored to not only have served on this board for the last 4 years, but it's an even bigger honor to represent our students in our district at the state level. I'm excited to continue to help Harrison School District 2 expand the work through policy to continue to set our students up for success. I'm sad to go off the board, but excited to have Dr. Pam Robinson join us. She is more than capable to lead on this board as well. And I just want to thank all my board members for grace and for putting up with me through the good and bad times, because at the end of the day, we're all here for the same reason, and that's to set our students up for success. So honestly, I'm really not going anywhere, because I'll still be doing school visits and things like that, and making sure our students, our educators, as well as our superintendent will continue to lean into the legislative process and make sure that our voice is heard through policy. And again, it's just been an honor to serve, so thank you.
And we're gonna do one last picture together. Us moving right along, item 11.2, annual work plan. Do we have any changes?
Yes, there will be, I was told, that there will be a board retreat in January. We just don't have a date for it yet. And that'll be part of working with the new board members.
Item 11.3, legislative updates.
There's a special session this weekend, and talking with lobbyists this morning, we're expecting more education bills than ever, which is not great news, but our representative is going to help make sense of those and make sure that we aren't told more things to do with less funding. So we will have a voice proactively in all those education bills. There will be a lot, we suspect, around school safety, school violence, school discipline. That's kind of the tone of what we're hearing from a lot of the bills that are supposed to be dropping. But we don't know yet, but we will have our voice as soon as we see them.
Thank you, Dr. Ransom. Item number 12 to Dr. English.
I move to adjourn the Board of Education meeting.
Wait. Item number 12.1. I would just need a motion. There we go.
I move to adjourn the Board of Education meeting.
I second.
Motion by Dr. English, second by Mrs. Salazar. All those in favor?
Aye.
Meeting adjourned.